Now we come to a very important equation in the electrochemistry that is called the Nernst equation. That is called the Nernst equation. Okay. What does this equation do? Till now we have been saying that that we know the standard electrode potential, and that is only when you have got the concentration of the electrolyte, the solution, as 1 m. Okay, so the values of electrode potentials are nothing but reduction potentials when the concentration of the solution is 1 m.
One molar.
Right. Now it is not essential that we always keep the concentration of solution as 1 m. I may like to vary the concentration. Okay. And I should be free to do that. Okay. And this is where the Nernst equation comes into play. Okay, so what does it do? It gives us a formula. To compute the electrode potential of any half cell at any concentration different from one molar. Okay, for one molar the standard electrode potentials are given to us, so I don't have to bother about that. So for example, when someone says that F2 plus 2 electrons give me 2F minus, what does it mean? This is 2.85 volt. It implies that this is for 1 molar concentration. 2.87 volt. That is for 1 molar concentration. Now I'd like to vary the concentration. What happens? Right? So this is where the Nernst comes into play. Right? Now it says that for a species with the reaction n plus n electron giving us m, this is in aqueous and this is solid. So the electrode potential of the half cell with reaction 1 with reaction 1 is reaction 1 at any concentration at any concentration measured with respect to the standard hydrogen electrode. Okay, standard hydrogen electrode is given by E for Mn plus this is the E
for manganese
for no it is Mn plus sorry it's not I'm sorry Mn plus 2m is given by the standard electrode potential minus RT upon NF into log M upon M of N plus. Okay? Fine. So this is the Nernst equation. Yes?
What is that?
F is Faraday's constant. I'll come to that. F is the Faraday's constant. Okay? Faraday's constant is F is Faraday's constant.
Or
is? Yes?
So minus,
not yeah. R is the universal gas constant. Universal gas constant, and the value is 8.314 for joule per mole or Kelvin, and T is temperature in Kelvin. Temperature in Kelvin. Faraday's constant is nothing but 1 mole of electrons, right? It is 1 mole of electrons. What is that? 1 mole of electron. Okay, F is equal to 1 mole of electrons. Now what should that be equal to? 6.02 into 10 to the power 23 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, which is equal to, okay, which is equal to 96487 coulomb. Okay, so this is a constant.
Charge on 1 mole of electron.
Yes. So charge on 1 mole of electron. Yes. Okay? Get the point? Now the concentration of a solid is 1. Concentration of solid is always 1. Okay? So what happens? So Nernst equation becomes, so let me write it here. Since
Coulomb per mole.
Yeah, that is Coulomb per mole, no? So many Coulomb per mole. So since M is equal to 1, as M is a solid, we have this is equal to the standard reduction electrode potential. The moment I say standard, it becomes that, minus RT upon NF, minus RT upon NF log on the natural base, right? M N plus. Correct?
N is L log. Why do we take plus? Concentration of
M2V1 solid. For solids or liquids, the concentration is taken as 1. For solids, the concentration is 1. I'll get back to you. Yes, you tell me. The with natural base.
E1.
Base E.
So this is 2.303 log 1.
Okay, so ultimately when you take the concentration of M as 1, it becomes this. But this is for a half cell. This is for a half cell at whatever concentration of the electrolyte, right? Or the solution. Correct? Now it can be utilized to find out the cell potential. Okay, since now I know all, I know this by the table, right? So from there, this is the deviation term. Okay, this is the deviation term. So this becomes with respect to the SHE, standard hydrogen electrode, right? This comes with respect to the hydrogen electrode, and what happens for the whole cell, you do just that, ER minus EL at whatever concentration. Understand? We understand what's being said. Okay, so that's how it will give you the cell potential for any cell. Okay, so let us try to apply this to the copper zinc cell that we have been dealing with from the beginning, right?